action cameras. You know, I do use the GoPro, especially on the kayak, but I mostly use these Midland head cams. The 280s I find are the best. I do have a 400 Midland, but I hate that the fact that it puts double files on. Anyway, I've got several Midlands. I even have the 285, the camouflage that doesn't beep for hunting. Anyway, I have a Midland XTC 280 here. It's a 1080p camera. And I have the Midland XTC 260, the 720p camera. Well, guess what? This one I just used the other day, and it works. But the microphones in them sometimes get a little scratchy. There's a microphone port right here, and sometimes it gets a little distorted, a little scratchy, and I've even tried putting it in a bag of rice or blowing it out with a can of air, and it just doesn't work. So we're going to see what's inside of these Midland head cams. What's inside the 280 and what's inside the 260, and we're going to compare the two. Okay, so we just took the side panel off. It just slides off. Took the battery out. We're going to use that as an extra battery on our good cameras. What we're going to do now is we've taken the four screws out with a little tiny screwdriver. Now we're going to pop this off. So that's a side panel. And it's got these little screws in here we're going to take out as well. I think there's three of them. Alright, so let's pull this thing apart. There's the top piece. That has a little magnet that slides and operates the on-off switch. Boy, it gets really dirty in there, don't it? That's the little thing for the lights. There's the back panel. You can see the SD card slot, the USB port. You got your high definition, your low definition switch, and then there's a reset button right there. You know, I didn't even know there was a reset button. Alright, let's take this front off. It has a cover on the round the lens, a rubber piece, and then a little lens. So that lens was scratched up a little bit. I don't know if you can see. Had some scratches on it. You know, you can technically replace that lens with another one if you had a good lens from another old camera. But that one's pretty scratchy, so I don't think we'll save that lens. But I didn't know. It looks to me like you can unscrew that without taking it apart. Alright, let's see if we can't pull this thing apart. Well, there's the microphone. That's the culprit right there. Has a little wind muffler on top of it. There's the little microphone. That's what goes bad in these cameras. I've never had the actual video part go bad, so only the microphone. Which, if you use your Zoom recorder or a Sony recorder or a Lexus recorder, you can just bypass that and still use it. I mean, this camera was still good. Took great video. Okay, it looks to me like the lens just came unplugged. So there's the main board. There's a reset button. The high definition, low definition. That's the little speaker that beeps when you're recording. There's the microphone. That's the other side of the USB port. I thought it had three lights, but apparently it's got one LED light that has three colors. And for the different modes, when your battery goes dead, it turns red. When you're recording, it turns red. When you first turn it on or you're charging, it's green. And if you're charging, it's blinking green. So I didn't know that it was just one bulb. So there's the back side of your SD card slot. You got your processor. That almost looks like a fusible link there, doesn't it? Anyway, that's the 1080p model. Let's look at the lens. So I guess that lens, if you had one that the lens went bad, I guess you could technically switch it out. If you had one that was scratchy, or one maybe that the lens went bad. So there's the lens. Now what else is in the case? You just got some copper foil, and then you have your tripod mount, which is secured in there. That's the back side of a screw. So there's a screw there that keeps that tripod mount in the camera. So there you go. There's the inside of a Midland action cam. That's the 1080p model. Let's take apart the 720 and see what the difference is. Okay, there's the inside of the 720p model. As you can see, it's almost the same. A little different. The microphone is the same. The lens is the main difference. Everything on the back side is pretty much the same. The lens is definitely different, but it's pretty much the same. There's a difference in the lenses. So if you ever wonder what was inside of a Midland action cam, there you go. So for the Virginia Stew, I'm Tom Moore. Good luck to you.